In this video, we are going to learn about forest, tree and domain. So we are going to discuss upon what is a forest, tree and then domain. So when it comes to the Active Directory, always we will be listening the terminology called as forest, tree and domain. So for example, you have created your first domain. Okay, you have created your first DC, the domain controller, with the domain is pyt courses.com. so it's pyt courses.com, and as this is your first domain controller, first DC, you will be calling it as a parent domain, and even this will be your root domain. This will be your root domain, means the main domain. So when it comes to the real time, the organizations will not be having only one domain, they will be having the multiple domains, because for each and every project, if they want to maintain only one domain, then that would be difficult for them to maintain the users, or if not, like to maintain the group policies and everything. So they will be having the multiple domains. So if the multiple domains are there, then they can create the separate environment for each and every project, whatever they require, and they can create the separate group policies, they can maintain the separate users, and they can maintain the separate computer, all the objects in that particular Active Directory, because for each and every domain there will be a separate Active Directory. So for example, here the PYT courses is an education institute. Okay, they have first set up their domain, that is the pyt courses.com, and this first domain will be calling it as the root domain or the parent domain. And now they are going to create the multiple domains, means the child domains. So they have another domain that is called as the upgradeyourself.pyt courses.com. so this is their another domain, and they also have one more domain. Okay, they also have one more domain that is called as online.pyt courses.com. so these are called as the child domains. Okay, the upgradeyourself.pyt courses.com and also the online.pyt courses.com, this will be called as the child domains. So this will be called as the child domains of the root domain. So the parent domain will be the main one, pyt courses.com, and for this pyt courses.com we have the child domains, like the upgradeyourself.pyt courses.com, and the other one is online.pyt courses.com. so the collection of domains, the collection of domains is called as a tree. So collection of domains is called as a tree. When someone asks you what is a tree, in a simple statement you can say that tree is nothing but the collection of domains. So if there are multiple domains, I mean like there is a parent domain and if there is a child domains, then the collection of these domains is called as a tree. So let me repeat again, like whatever we have discussed till now. So first I have created my main domain, the domain controller, that is for the pyt courses.com domain. Okay, so this, the first domain which we created, that is called as the root domain, or if not the parent domain. So as I said earlier, each and every organization, they will not be having only one domain, they will be having multiple domains, because for few projects they want to create the separate group policies, or they want to create the separate environment. So for example, here we have the child domain as upgradeyourself.pyt courses.com. So For example, as I said earlier, this is an education institute, pydcourses.com. So if someone wants to go with the offline classes, then they will be under this upgradeyourself.pydcourses.com. And if someone want to go with the online classes, then they will be coming under the online.pydcourses.com. So for each and every domain, there will be a separate active directory. For the root domain, they will be having the separate active directory. And also for the child domains, they will be having the separate active directory. So it would be easy to maintain the users, and it will also be easy to apply the group policy. So for upgradeyourself.pydcourses.com, they can create the separate environment, and even for the online.pydcourses.com, they can create the separate environment. So the combination of domains, the combination of multiple domains is called as a tree. And when it comes to the forest, the forest is automatically created when we create our first domain. Okay, so when we create our first domain, so when we created our first domain, pydcourses.com, then the forest is automatically created. So this we will be calling it as the logical structure. So when this forest will be created, this forest will be created automatically when we create our first domain. Okay, when we create our first domain, then the logical structure, which is called as the forest, will be automatically created. And all the child domains will be added to the same forest. And like all the domains, okay, and all the domains in the forest. Okay, so we have three domains, right? So for all the domains in the forest, they have something in common. Okay, so all the three domains, they will be having one thing in common, and that is called as the schema. What we'll be calling that? We'll be calling it as the schema. So what this schema means? So what this schema will be doing? So schema, this defines the Active Directory database. So what this schema will do? It defines the Active Directory database. So this schema, it will be defining the Active Directory database. So let me change this color. Yes. And it determines, this schema, it determines what can be stored in the database and the structure of the data. So what all the data that need to be stored in the database will be decided by the schema, and even the structure of the data also will be decided by the schema. So each domain has its own copy of the database, but it is the schema that determines its design, and the schema is shared between all the domains in the forest. So the schema is shared between all the domains in the forest. And if any changes are made to the schema, these changes are replicated to every domain in the forest. So if we make any changes to the schema, then the changes will be replicated for all the domains in the forest. And the main advantage of having the forest. So we will be having the advantage of having the forest, and the main advantage is the trust relationship. Okay, the trust relationship will be automatically developed between the domains in the forest. So here we have the parent domain and the child domain. The parent domain is the pyetcourses.com and the child domain is the upgradeyourself.pyetcourses.com. So between these two domains, the trust relationship will be automatically developed. Okay, the trust relationship will be automatically developed. Okay, so it will, the trust relationship will be automatically developed between the parent domain and the child domain in the forest. And one more thing, so for example, okay, so if someone from the upgradeyourself.pyetcourses.com domain and if someone from the upgradeyourself.pyetcourses.com domain want to access the resources from the main domain, which is pyetcourses.com. Okay, so then they need to know the data, right? They need to know where is the resource, right? So for that, we need an index. So in order to find the items in the forest, we need an index. Index means nothing but we can call it as a library. So we all know, right? Library means where we can get all the information. In the same way here in the Active Directory, if in the Active Directory, if someone from the other domain wants to, I mean like the child domain wants to access the resource of parent domain, they should know like where all the resources are available. So that information will be maintained in the index. Index, we can call it as a library. So in any Active Directory forest, there will be a server that provide an index for all the items in the forest. And these are called as the global catalog. These are called as the global catalog. And there will be at least one global catalog server per domain. So for each and every domain, there will be at least one global catalog server. What this global catalog server will do? The global catalog server will contain the index of every object in the forest. So this global catalog server will be having the index of every object in the forest. Object is nothing but the resources, the data, whatever that is stored in the directory, that is called as an object. And the global catalog contains the basic information of each object in the forest. So it will be maintaining the basic information of each object in the forest. So this is what meant by an forest, tree and domain in the Active Directory. Thank you for watching this video. If you feel that this video is helpful for you, please do subscribe our channel and don't forget to like this video.